Welcome back to our video lecture series. So this is now the second part of Unit 7, which is locations and directions. The first part, we learned about very important vocabulary on locations and directions. And there were also examples given in a certain picture or a scenario or a certain setting where you can find things and how could we ask the location of something and how could we also answer the location of something. So at this point, let us try to intensify our discussion on the example that we had last video lecture, and we'll start with asking whether an item exists or not. Again, asking whether an item exists or not. So take note, this is our dialogue. So in English, we do have here a question. Do you have a computer in your room? And your answer is yes, I do. So let's try to take a look at. So here it is. Let us listen to the audio file. So let's start first with, do you have a computer in your room?
방에 컴퓨터가 있어요?
So, 방에 컴퓨터가 있어요? Okay, 방에 컴퓨터가 있어요? 방에 컴퓨터가 있어요? Okay, 있어요. Remember, you have to have a rising intonation because this is a question, right? And then the answer, if you have, you will just say, 네, 있어요.
네, 있어요.
네, 있어요. Okay, don't forget, you have to pause after 네, a little bit of, you know, stop, and then 있어요. So it is an affirmation that you do have that thing, okay, or that appliance or whatever it is being asked. So 방에 컴퓨터가 있어요. Remember, 'cause 방, it means room, and 에 here is our location marker. And then we do have 컴퓨터. This is of course computer. And then 가 is subject marker, and then 있어요 is like exist or do you have, okay? And then when you answer it, you just say 네, 있어요, because you have it. Okay, so let's listen again.
방에 컴퓨터가 있어요?
네, 있어요.
Okay, moving forward. So we have here very important grammar points. It's a noun that we are going to attach a subject particle, which is 이 and 가, and the noun which we are going to attach 에. Okay, and then 있다, 없다. Okay, 있다, it means there is an existence of something. 없다 means nothing, okay? So there's none. Now, the noun here, we have 이 and 가. So 있어요, it means that noun is located or exists. While when we say a noun and then we attach 이 or 가, remember, when do we use 이 and when do we use 가? If the noun ends with a consonant, we added 이, okay? For example, example of a noun that ends with a consonant is, we have the window, 창문. Okay, so when we are going to consider it as our subject, you are going to say 창문이. Okay, and then an example for a noun that ends in a vowel is, we do have 의자. Okay, 의자, it means chair, so we could say 의자가. Okay, well, there are a lot of nouns that ends in consonants and vowels. So you have to know what does it end. If it ends in a consonant, of course, there is a batchim, right? If it ends with a vowel, it has no batchim. So remember what to add. If it is E, is it E or ga? Remember, consonant, E, and then vowel is ga. So if we are going to say noun and then attach it with E or ga is soyo, it means that the noun is located or it is, it exists. While when we have noun plus the e or ga and then opsoyo, it means the opposite, which is none. Okay, well, noun plus e is used with, okay, it will be used alongside with a noun plus e or ga isoyo to show where the noun that you are referring to is located. Okay, so I hope it makes sense, huh? Noun plus the e here is our location marker. So definitely, the noun that we are referring here, most likely it's a place, okay? Or it is where the noun that you're asking for is located. So it is used alongside with the expression noun i or ga isoyo to show where the noun is located. I hope it makes sense and it is clear. Let's move on. Okay, so we have here another dialogue, which is of course still the same. It is to ask whether an item exists or not. So let's try to take a look at here. We are still considering the picture beside, which is your room. Imagine this is your room. So our question here, do you have a closet in your room? And then the answer is no, I don't. If we are going to take a look at it, there is no closet at all. So let's play the audio file.
방에 옷장이 있어요?
Okay. 방에 옷장이 있어요? You know, 옷 is clothes, huh? 옷, but 옷장, it becomes closet. And then we do have here, 이, this is our subject marker. And then 에 here is our location marker. So obviously this sentence or this question is asking where or do you have or is there a closet in your room or do you have a closet in your room? So we have here
방에 옷장이 있어요?
방에 옷장이 있어요. Okay? 방에 옷장이 있어요. And then since there's none, you don't have it.
아니요. 없어요.
아니요. 없어요. So of course, class, dili ni pwede magkuyog si anyo isoyo. No, it should they should not go together. They don't collocate with one another. But rather, anyo opsoyo goes together, and then anyo opsoyo they go together, and then we have ne isoyo go together as well. So dili pwede nga i-mix and match. Nani mga partners ni silang, okay? Anyo is partnered with opsoyo, opsoyo, and the ne will be with isoyo. Okay, now let's try to take a look at this practice. Okay, so asking whether an item exists or not. So ask your partner, or you know, just ask yourself na lang, no? Because of course you are in your respective areas, and probably in your family right now you're the only one learning Korean language. So ask your partner if he or she has the following items. So we are going to take a look at TV, okay? Or television. Television. Now let's take a look at the room, you know, that this person has. Is there a TV? So definitely, the question will be, 방에 텔레비전이 있어요? Okay. 방에 텔레비전이 있어요? This will be our question because we are learning here how to ask question and how to answer. So since this is the question, 방에 텔레비전이 있어요? Is there a TV? The answer will be 아니요, 없어요, because there is none, right? So I hope you're able to get it. For the next slide, I don't have to explain what to do. Just automatically take a look at it in the picture here if the item being encircled can be found in the room. All right, so let's continue. Okay, here, this is a bed. You know, bed, it's 침대, right? 침대. So it will be 방에 침대가 있어요. Okay, remember class, this is our location. Okay, this is a noun, 방, room. And then this is the location of the noun or the something that we ask its existence, right? 침대, it's a bed, and it ends in a vowel. That's why we use the noun particle 가 and then 있어요. So 방에 침대가 있어요. 방에 침대가 있어요. Okay, so you have to remember that. So of course, is there? Yeah. So 네 있어요. 네 있어요. 방에 침대가 있어요. Okay. Remember, class, when we are going to say it in Korean language, no, this is my common mistake as well. It's the interference, of course, of our L1, our native language, which is Cebuano, and even our L2, which is English. So sometimes I tend to forget that Korean language, we should not have intonation in between or high pitch levels in between. What I mean is we always begin with a pitch level to normal lang na when we start conversation. Di jud ta mag-increase atong pitch, no? Consistent ra gyud ta nga pitch level 2 unless if it is rising intonation, we go pitch level 3, pero aray na talapita, and then if it is a falling, we go pitch level 1. So, punang mo down ang ato ang pitch. So, we are going to say, bangye chimde ga isoyo. Okay, bangye chimde ga isoyo. Okay, so, ne isoyo, because there is the bed. Next, this one, ref. What is ref? Okay, we learned it earlier, neng janggu, right? So, bangye neng janggu ga isoyo? 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 Okay, so is there a ref in the room? Of course, there's not. So, mingun dayon nga, anyo, opsoyo. Okay, remember that, how to say it? We begin with the location, but you can also actually kind of interchange this, like you would say, "Nengjanggu ga bange isoyo." It's also fine, okay? But in the example given, we begin first with our location and then the expression noun, "iga isoyo." So let's just probably follow that pattern first. But in case you can't see a certain pattern or a question, nagiuna ni siya sulti class ang subject, then after ng location, that's fine. Okay, you can say "neng janggu ga bange isoyo." All right, so let's move on. Next is the telephone, chonwa, right? Okay, bange chonwa ga isoyo? Is there a telephone? Bange chonwa ga isoyo? Bange chonwa ga isoyo? Okay, there is right here. So ne isoyo. Okay, next. We do have here pillow. Pillow is bige. So bige, bange bige ga isoyo. Okay, bange bege ga isoyo. Bege ga isoyo. Okay, bange bege ga isoyo. Bege ga isoyo. Bange bege ga isoyo. Okay, remember that. And there is, right? We have it here. So ne isoyo. Next is, okay, utjang. So closet. Is there a closet? Definitely there is. So the question will be, bange utjangi isoyo? Bange utjangi isoyo? Right? That is the question. So your answer will be, ne isoyo. Okay. Next is, we have sopa. Sopa. Is there a sopa? There's none. No, wala sa picture. So the question will be, bange sopa ga isoyo? Sopa ga isoyo? Bange sopa ga isoyo? Bange sopa ga isoyo? So, anyo, opsoyo, opsoyo. Okay, next, computer. Okay, computer. Okay, is there? Okay, so I think you can see there, it's there. So, bange computer ga isoyo? Bange computer ga isoyo? Ne, isoyo. Right? Next is we have, what is this one? This is 책상, no? Desk. So, we are going to ask, bange 책상이 isoyo? Bange 책상이 isoyo? So, is there a desk? Yes, there is. So, you would say, ne, isoyo. Okay, pero kung napaibag unta diri class like kabang, no, yung in circulan, then would the question will be, bange kabang ni isoyo? Okay, nabay kabang sa room because bang means room, no? So your answer would also be ne isoyo. Napagitay uija. Uija is the chair. Okay, so you could also ask bange uija ga isoyo, and then ne isoyo. And then we also have clothes. Bange 옷이 있어요? 네, 있어요. Pero, 나아바이 사진, I mean picture. So, I will be asking you, 방에 사진이 있어요? Okay, the answer will be 아니요, 없어요. 그러니까 my picture, no frame or whatsoever. So this is our asking whether an item exists or not. First practice. Let's go on with the second practice. So the second practice for this part is we are going to complete the sentence. The sentence as shown in the example. No? So we have here 모기, 책상. We have 책상, 의자. So 책상이 있어요. So 무나 ang sentence ng primero, no? 책상이 있어요. 의자가 없어요. Okay, so kanina ang primero, 책상, and then if naaba siya, we are going to say 있어요, and if there's none, 없어요. So let's start with the first. So always take note, class, that we are now also learning new vocabulary here, no? And then let's try to take a look at here. The first is 지도, and then 지게. 지도, this is map. Okay, and then 지게 is clock. Clock. Is there a map? Yes, there is. So you are going to say 지도 is 지도가 있어요. Is there a clock? 와라. So you are going to say 지도가 있어요. 지게가 없어요. Right? Okay. Next. 사전. 사전 is dictionary, and then 휴대폰. 휴대폰 is cell phone, okay, or handy phone. So, is there a 사전? Yes. But is there a 휴대폰? 나바이 휴대폰? None, right? So you're going to say 사전이 있어요, and then 휴대폰이 없어요. Okay. Next is 연필. 연필, and then 지우개. So, is there a 연필? Try to take a look at the picture. 나아바긋? Okay, there is, right? These are the 연필. But is there a 지우개? Eraser. Is there? There's none. So you're going to say 연필이 있어요. 지우개가 없어요. Okay? So remember, class, when we pronounce, if something ends with a batchim and if it will be followed by a syllable that nag-una niya is iyong or silent, kanisyang batchim na to, it will go up and it will be carried over. That's why you're going to say yonpiri. Okay? Pero way batchim parehan, we are going to pronounce it as yonpil. Okay? Yonpil. Pero kay na may batchim, you're going to say yonpiri. Okay? Yonpiri isoyo. Jiugega opsoyo. Okay? So, let's end our part 2 in this slide, and please always don't forget to look forward with our part 3 of unit 7, locations and directions. Thank you very much, everyone, and I will talk with you on the next video lecture. Bye, 안녕.